Hey guys, my name's Jason, and behind me are hundreds of bags of gold ore that I pulled out of my gold mine this last fall. So what I've done is I've taken a bag from each one of these pallets, and I'm gonna go through and grab a sample from each bag, and that's gonna be a representative sample, kind of all the pallets I have down here, and that's gonna help us determine kind of an average value of how much gold I might have in my ore. I've been selling these bags on eBay, so if you wanna try your hand at one of these bags and see how much gold you can get, you can check out our eBay listings. And a lot of people have been finding some really, really good stuff in here, some really nice golden quartz samples. So you can find that information in the description below. And so for today's video, I'm gonna show you how I would process some of this stuff and get the gold out. So the first thing I wanna do is run through this stuff, see if I can find any gold specimens in it. And then we'll get it crushed down and see what we can get for gold. I've got this weighed at 7 kilograms. We're gonna go with the metric system today because it's so much easier. Well, the first thing I wanna do is I wanna screen it to 1" minus. This is gonna get all the fines through that I don't have to look for specimens in, and it'll leave all the coarse stuff right on top. If you do this, you might wanna make it a little bit finer. There's still some pretty good chunks in there that might have gold, so you might want to maybe go to 1/2 inch. But right now we'll start with 1 inch, see if we can find any gold in the coarse stuff. Here's our coarse stuff. There's a little bit of waste in there just because when we're mucking we can't pick out every little piece. So let me get this washed off a little bit. We'll see if we can find some gold. And I'm looking around these sulfides here. There's some gray stuff in there. If I can find that stuff, that usually gives me a pretty good idea. And you can take these and actually break them up further if you wanted to. Take a look at some of the fresh faces. Well, I've been looking that long and there's a little tiny piece right here. There's a couple little pieces right over here. So we found our first gold specimens. I'm gonna set this rock out and we're gonna cut it up a little later and see if we can find some more gold in it. Here's another little piece right here with some gold on it. So we're finding it. There's two pieces now. I've gone through, I don't know, a dozen rocks. Found a couple little specimens with gold on it. We'll put him aside as well. I've washed all of our 1 inch and coarser stuff. And this is the stuff I didn't see any gold in. What you really want to do is take a scrub brush and brush off some of the dirt and stuff that I didn't get to, but this water's really cold. I don't have gloves. So we're gonna crush this stuff down. Here's some waste I pulled out. This just doesn't have anything in it. You might want to play with it a little bit or crush it down separately, see if there's any values in there. But I pulled that out, and then I've got our two pieces here that show gold on them. So now let's go take a look at our fine stuff, and we'll run it all through the crusher. We're going to start here with this little 4x6 laboratory jaw crusher. Feed the rocks down the jaws. Out in this tray here, crushed, and then we'll run them through the fine crusher. Here's a look at our stuff through the pulverizer. Now a lot of the gold has been liberated now. It's been broken away from the quartz. So now we can pan it out. It's gonna take me 2 or 3 pans to get all this stuff panned out. But now I'm gonna work this down, pan it down until only the densest stuff is left. We'll see what we got. I've got everything panned out now. The black stuff is the iron heavies. Everything yellow in here is gold. And there's not as much fine gold as I thought, but the trick to hard rock gold is to crush it really, really fine. The finer you can crush it, the more you can liberate. But we've got some really nice pieces here. I mean, that's a picker. I just picked that one right up out of the pan. And they get kind of rolled up in the disc mill. Here's one that didn't, another picker. That's a really nice little piece right there. I wish I would have found him in the rock. That would have been a really nice specimen. So now what we're going to do is we're going to get all this gold out of here. We're going to melt it down and see how big of a bead we have. And then we'll take our rocks over with the specimens and cut those open, see if we can find some more gold. I'm going to take my snuffer bottle. I'm just going to go along and get as much gold as I can. I'll do that a couple times so I can get all the value out of this I can. I got all my gold in the snuffer bottle now. I'm going to pull out my straw, cap the end with my finger, and shake all of our goodies right down to the very tip here. And then I can get them out in this little blue shop towel thing. And then we can put them right in our cupel and smelt them down. It's actually a lot of gold for 7 kilograms. So there we go. I'll wring some of that water out. And we'll be left with our little gold packet at the bottom. We'll open our furnace. Cupel's heating up there. Gonna take our little gold packet, put it in our cupel. Put some bismuth right on top. The bismuth is gonna alloy with the gold and silver. As it gets up to temperature and liquefies, the bismuth will oxidize, absorb into the cupel, and leave a precious metal button in the cupel when it's all done. Well, I wanted to switch gears here a little bit. I've brought some of the quartz pieces over to the rock shop, and I want to get these cut up. I really, really like cutting them into those pillars that I've done in the past. We've got some really nice sulfide banding here, all through here. This is gonna be a really cool piece as well. I'm working on trying to figure out a name for this stuff. I've got some ideas I'm gonna share with you a little later, but I'm gonna put a poll up on one of my YouTube community posts. So if you wanna vote on what to name this stuff, check out that poll. I'll put a link to it in the description. But right now we'll get this stuff chucked up in the saws and see if we can, one, find any gold, but two, see if we can make some really nice art pieces out of these coarse chunks of gold ore. I got this first long skinny one chucked up here. I'm gonna cut it right in half, and then I'll probably slab off a side of a face, and we'll see what it looks like. This is really a fun part for me because I don't really have an idea of what this is gonna turn into. And as I start cutting on it and looking at it, I kind of, the rock tells me what it wants to be. So it's kind of a cool thing. But for this one, I think we'll get two different pieces out of it. Well, here's our first piece. Oh, good looking stuff there. This will be cool as a little stand up. All right, here's a look at our first stand up here. Oh yeah, let me get it cleaned up a little bit and in the light so we can see it. And here it is in the sunlight. Man, that is cool. So I've got two cut faces, a base, and then I really like leaving a couple sides natural rough like that, so you can kind of see the original look of it. But man, that is cool. That is so neat. I've been cutting some really cool stuff. I really, really like the look of a lot of this stuff. Some slabs, some stand-ups. I've got some smooth faces. I've got some rough faces. Really, really cool stuff. But what I'm most excited about, I've been saving these two rocks in particular. I think I can fit them in my saw, but they've got, this one has this really, really nice band. I think this is right where the gold is. I think there might even be a piece of gold right there, actually. And right there too. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try and get this one in the saw and slab it across this vein and see if we can get a really nice juicy couple of faces on this one. This one I've been excited about because here's the hanging wall, very well defined wall. There's that band of sulfides coming right across. So same thing, I'm gonna slab this one. Instead of going across the mineralization this way, I'm gonna try and slab it this way and see if we can get some really nice sulfide showing and maybe a little bit of gold. Okay, I've got it chucked up. I'm not sure how this is gonna go, but we're gonna give it a shot. I've been whittling through that big piece with the streaks in it that I liked. And the first couple here didn't have any gold in it, But I've been cutting these kind of cabochon blanks, I guess. They're about a quarter inch or 5/16 thick. They've got some really beautiful pyrrhotite in them, that iron sulfide that I have. And then here about number 5 or 6, I started getting into a little bit of gold I wanted to show you. A little bit here. I was finding some down along here. There's a little piece. And as I started getting further and further into the piece, the gold kept getting better and better. Once we started getting up to the spot where I saw those bands, there's some right up in here. See, there's some of that free gold, some more over here. But this last piece I cut off, we must be getting into the thick of it because I'm getting some really, really good stuff here. Right in here and right down here. Look at that big old piece of gold. And then as you come up here, you got to get it in the light just right to see it in the camera, but all that yellow right in there is all gold. So I'm really excited to see what the next one comes out as, because I think we're right in that band where all the gold is, and I'm getting some really, really good showings. Let's see if we can find any gold in these two pieces I pulled out. I've just got a 10-inch tile saw, got off Craigslist. This is an awesome way to start cutting rocks. First one, I cut several different slabs off. It didn't find anything. And then I looked down in the saw, and I think this came off of there. But there's definitely some gold in that one right there. So that's a nice little piece. And then this one, I cut it the wrong direction. I thought I was gonna cut parallel with these bands and get some gold, but it turns out every one of these slabs has a little bit on it, nothing fantastic, but right up here by my thumb, right there. And then on the corresponding face, there's some nice stuff, all pretty small. But what I should have done is come across this band right here, and I would have got some really nice showing. But every face has a little bit on it. Yeah, this one might actually be the best one. Up here, over there. So a couple of nice slabs out of that one. Well, here's a couple pieces of rail I drug out from the mine this year. And what I'd like to do is get this stuff cut up into about 6-inch pieces. I've got some spikes as well. Figure a piece of rail, a spike, and a piece of ore would be a nice little package for someone. Let me show you how this works. Got a nice little stack of them going there. And here's what I'm thinking for this rail. So we got our piece of rail, we got a spike, and then we can get a nice piece of gold ore. Some of these will have gold in them. There's some gold right here, here on the face. But wouldn't that look cool? Just on your little museum shelf there. Here's another one. This one has a lot more sulfides in it. This one's pretty cool, but there's quite a bit of gold right in here. Kind of speckled throughout the sulfides on this one. And these are just cut flat faces, rough on the outside. Here's another option. Might throw in a few of these where they're slabs, cut both faces so they can stand up there. Well, let's take a look at our bead here. It's all finished up. I'm gonna pull it out. Nice little gold bead there. Nice one. Very cool. Let's get it cooled off and we'll weigh it. Our bead's cooled down a little bit. Take a look here. That is a very, very nice little bead there. Nice gold color. Let's get it weighed, see how much gold we got. Okay. Total comes to 0.42 grams out of 7 kilograms, or about 15 pounds. And here's our math. We have our grams of gold divided by 0.007 metric tons. It gives us 59.6 grams per ton, or almost 2 troy ounces per ton. Unbelievably rich. Well, here's another question for you guys. I mentioned earlier in the video that I want to name this stuff, and I've gotten a ton of comments from you guys in the last couple weeks about what I should name my rock. Here are 4 of the top ideas. So the first one is White Iron Nebula Stone. The second one is Cascade Cloud Stone. I had Cascade Iron Lace. And the last one is Mount Baker Lightning Quartz. So I've got a poll going right now on my community page. I'll leave a link in the description below. You guys can go over there and vote on what you want to name this stuff. I've got my favorite choice, but it might not be what you guys vote for. So head on over, vote, and then we'll figure out what to name my rock. Well, that's gonna wrap it up for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to support me and support my mining efforts, I've got all the stuff listed on eBay. And I know some of you are rolling your eyes like, oh man, he's sold out. Now he's just selling all this stuff on eBay. But the truth is, I've got to pay for the mining somehow. The whole point of mining was to go up there and get some gold and get some ore. I've got bags of fine ore. I've got bags of coarse ore if you want to crush some stuff. I've got a ton of stuff that I've cut. A lot of it has gold in it. I got the rail stuff. And all the money that comes from this stuff is going right back in the hole next year. I also have a Patreon page. You can check that out. I'll put a link in the description below. So thanks everybody for all your support over the years. I appreciate you guys watching. And we'll see you on the next video.